Here's let's go to Andy. Andy, you're on the Ron and Fez show. How you doing, buddy?
Hey, how are you guys?
Yeah.
Hey, my comment is the violent video games, everybody's blaming the kids if they get in trouble on that. But correct me if I'm wrong, all the games are rated NC-17 or something like that. And it's the fucking parents that buy these video games for the kids. So essentially they're turning them into the devils. Or
well, I don't know if you've ever been to a store, but it's I'm going to cut you off so I can do this. But there's always a little kid standing next to an adult telling them what they have to have. Because the adult obviously doesn't know one way or another. And they run up so much cash now. Just hang around a store and watch. You'll see a kid that's 5 or 6 telling, no, these are the sneakers I need. This is the skateboard I need. These are the games I need. And the parents just buy them for it.
I would never know. If I was there with a kid,
nobody does. No adult knows what. How would you know what the fucking cool sneakers are if you're an adult?
But beat me.
New Balance. Look at these.
You wear them and love it.
These are comfortable. I've tried everything on, son. These are the most comfortable shoes. You know, just like you didn't want to wear the shoes your dad wore, these kids don't want to wear what you're wearing.
I know it's a generational thing, but I couldn't even say that to my parents, like, I have to have this.
No.
It would just, I mean.
Some kids could, though. You had spoiled friends, and you know it.
Oh, totally. But,
yeah.
But at the same, my parents, it was just like, this is what you're getting. You're
right.
Going to like it. It's like, unless you get a job
right.
And start paying your own
but
bills.
But you remember what it felt like not to have cons when you needed cons.
Yeah.
Not to have Nikes when you needed that.
No, I mean, but at the same token, my parents were hip enough to know what. They were in tune with what kids bought.
No, they were black. Try growing up with white parents.
It's awful.
I know. We always had pro kids. We didn't have the ones with the three stripes on it, but we had the pro kids. We had we were close. We were either close.
My mom always tried to talk me out of cons. They fall apart. Yes. What could be cooler?
Me, it was the Chuck Taylors.
Chuck Taylors were the coolest. All right, let's bring in Bill, the weird intern. He's of the age of all this. He's just a youngster. You seem like an odd, violent guy. Do you play video games at all, Bill?
Yes, I do. Not as much now as I used to, but...
What's the video game of choice? What one were you obsessed with in your life?
I obsessed with games made by the company Square Enix. And that's only because I've been collecting them for years, and
mm-hmm.
It's more of a compulsion now.
What kind of games are we talking about?
We're talking about role-playing games mostly, console role-playing games, and that's about it.
First-person shooter?
I play a little bit of those because I need something to play for 10 minutes and stop playing
right.
When I'm doing work and stuff. The other games, I take hours playing.
Do you have weird fantasies? I know you don't like women much, right?
Well, I have... let's say low, not respect, but low faith in women, mostly, especially from Long Island.
So the Long Island girls, the worst women on the planet.
Yes.
She devils.
What have they done to you? Would you say you hate them?
I hate that mentality they all have.
Are you comfortable around women?
Yes. Especially,
could you hang
setting.
Out with women? Could you spend the night just you and two or three girls?
Yes.
And be comfortable with that? Because a lot of young guys can't.
Yes, I could hang out with women. It depends if I'm drunk or not, like what my level of
comfortability
and,
will be.
And what I might say.
Would you need some alcohol to do it?
Depends how much, if it's new people.
What if it was sex? Could you flirt with a woman without drinking first?
Yes, but I would think I would do much better if I was drinking a bit.
What would you say to a woman?
Well,
if you were attracted to her.
And am I drinking or not drinking?
Let's say not drinking.
I would just start talking to someone, and then if they seemed interested in me, just...
Do you fantasize about them immediately?
I would assume no. I can't really... I'm not really too sure about that.
You have trouble fantasizing?
No. Just offhand, if I see a woman, I'm not sure if I would fantasize right away and then talk to them or not.
Do you fantasize about famous women or women that you know?
Women that I know.
Mm-hmm. About hurting them?
Nah.
Bill?
Well, there's women I hate,
mm-hmm.
But that has nothing to do with the women that I like.
Specific women that you hate?
No, just generally.
Or you just hate a type you see walking
down
the street.
You hate a Long Island woman.
Well, like those Italian women from like the Puerto Rican Italian, like every girl.
Dark women.
Like every girl that has like money on Long Island that mm-hmm. really, like that whole fucking mentality that you just like shop at malls and then you grow up and get married and then you divorce your husband when you become around 40 because you stop going out with the family, you stop when you get married and then you realize you're getting older and then you realize you're going to have your last hurrah and then you stop you start going out more and you find reasons to hate your husband and then you divorce him.
You come from a divorced family?
No, but I do see those attributes in my mom.
Mom dates?
Not now.
Yeah. But she did?
No. I wouldn't know, though. I hardly ever go home.
Yeah, because you don't feel comfortable there.
Well, I don't feel comfortable around my family at all, so right. That's why I don't basically go home.
If you do go home, it'll be with a rifle.
Yeah. If I go home, I get angry instantly once I walk into that house.
Right.
Happy holidays.
Did something happen that made you feel this way?
I don't know. It's when my dad was dying, it got really weird around the house. He got really weird. He started becoming depressed and freaking out a lot. And
I wonder why.
Mom was
he was dying. So mom was never not hanging around while dad was dying?
To me, she really wasn't that much.
She was dating. Well, you think she was?
I couldn't make a call on that, but I definitely had to play adult in that family.
Right.
I had to be the one that, when dad freaked out, I had to be the one that said, hey, blah, 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 this isn't, calm down, this, blah, blah, blah. And like, I had to be the one that talked to mom and said, hey, dad's in this mood, you have to be around
right.
him.
So you went through a really stressful time.
Oh, yeah, for 1 or 2 years, whatever it was.
Makes you hate women.
I hate.
But what they did to you.
Well, I see what I'm talking about in a lot of women from where I come from. I've seen many people I know get divorced. I see it's just that mentality. I see the kids are now growing up in families that are only all the parents are working,
right.
And they have nannies. And then like when they grow up and you talk to them, you find out they actually are a lot of their beliefs come from the nannies they had and stuff like that, like religion.
A lot of kids are into voodoo because their nannies were Jamaican. For you, they put you on a lot of drugs.
No,
the family, you're on a lot of drugs now though, right?
No, Adderall, but beside that...
What's that?
I mean, drugs that doctors prescribe for me, no, I'm not on a lot of those, just Adderall.
What's Adderall?
Adderall is like, it's like nitrous in a Honda Civic.
Mm-hmm.
It
just jumps you up?
Yeah, it makes you work a lot faster and a lot more efficient.
Is it like doing crystal meth? Have you ever done meth?
I haven't done actual crystal meth, but I've heard that... Basically, Adderall is that, and there's a way to actually turn Adderall into it.
So you're cranked up all the time. You're basically super amped.
Yep, and my psychiatrist, who doesn't actually talk to me about anything, I just walk and get the prescription. He basically says to me, right. Hey, you're doing everything right. Here's another prescription. Here's another 60 pills.
Just a refill. Yeah. You take the Adderall every day?
I used to have that, but I called it my dealer. And he'd be like, you're doing everything right. You're making something out of yourself. Here, snort this. So you take your, you get amped up every day, and the more amped up you are, the more you dislike women.
Well, I don't get amped up every day. It's just the days that I have to usually go to school or work. But if I don't have to, I don't take it.
So you got to be high to come to work. You got to be cranked up to come to work. Everybody says you're doing a good job, but it's because you're just fucking flying around here, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
What happens if you don't take your Adderall? What are you like?
I'd work pretty well, but I don't think I'd be as... on my feet about...
Oh, you wouldn't like him, Fez, if he didn't take Adderall.
Like, mentally, I don't think I could pick up and jump onto something as quickly.
Can you have sex on this drug?
Yes.
Hmm.
Everything but Oxycontin. That's where the problems happen.
You had Oxycontin?
I've had Oxycontin.
Right. From your shrink?
From my dad's pills.
Oh, good. So while dad's dying, he's like, I'm suffering. I need something. Wait a minute. Who ate all these? Bill. Bill.
No, this is after.
Oh, after he died.
And I made
empty again.
Yeah.
That's when those came and went and stuff.
So you're not dating now?
Currently, no. I have no time for anything involving school or socially.
All right. So that's a problem. We don't want you as an intern not having time for school.
No, I go to classes and stuff. And
because
I
when you fail out of school and you don't get a job in radio, you're going to come back here and kill everybody at XM.
No,
we worry.
Because your internship will go with it.
That's definitely what I don't want. But I think I'm doing good with school.
I don't know. I met Bill a year ago. He drove down to D.C. when we were working there. Gave me a scary script and a bunch of cigars, which I appreciate it. And then we all waved goodbye, and I go, there's one scary kid. And then I thought, well, you know, I'll just write back to him and say, hey, aggressive script is what I actually wrote back to him. Because it was, you know, about forcing women to have abortions. And
no, but it was in a comedy aspect.
Yes, though. I know. That's what scared me most of all, that you found it humorous.
Funny.
So, you know, punching women in stomachs and stuff like that while they're pregnant. So I just wrote back, hey, aggressive script, good luck with it. And then when I walked back in next time and he was here, it was just like, I know what you did last summer too, where you feel like you're away from the scary person, and but they're still here.
You turn the corner and there's the killer.
Grish wants to talk to you. Grish, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, what's up? I just want to say that Adderall is for ADD. It's the same shit that, like, Ritalin. We used to take it in college for finals to break it up and snort it. It's called Poor Man's Coke.
Right.
Yeah. Kids pay a lot for that Adderall here.
So you know that. You feel like you're coked up a little bit.
I feel like my wallet's a little thicker sometimes. Mm-hmm. During midterms.
What's he mean by that? Like he sells it?
He's selling his own prescription.
All these kids that are on the drugs, they're college kids and high school kids, they either sell it for money or they're trading. There's like trading parties where they all get together and I'll give you two downs for these, you know, ups.
Are you supposed to be taking it every day? I know you said you didn't.
No, because Adderall is unlike Ritalin, you can take Adderall when you want. You don't have to take it every day. And when you stop Adderall, you don't have to take less dosage and less.
Can you sleep on it, though?
No.
No.
Absolutely.
So that's a problem.
No.
So just letting you know, as you're getting into a new business and you're trying to figure out, you don't want to go through it amped on drugs because now you don't know whether you really can do it or not without drugs.
Well, I still think I could do it without it. I haven't been taking anything that I haven't been doing for a year or two, and sometimes I've been here without taking Adderall sometimes.
I want to just give you a little test, psychological test, right?
Okay.
All right, if you're sitting here with Fez, and there's a knife,
mm-hmm.
Do you stab him?
No.
Why did you have to think about that?
Yeah, there was kind of a hesitance there.
Mm. Well, I don't. What type of knife are we talking about? I mean, maybe
a hunting knife.
Well, no.
Shouldn't matter.
Let me ask you this. Fez's head, does it look better on his shoulders or cut off and you wearing it as a hat?
On his shoulders, of course.
Okay. Good one.
Yeah.
All right, that one didn't seem like it came to you better.
You're doing everything right.
You don't want to wear his head as a hat, do you?
No.
Bill?
No. Even though it's funny, the image, but...
Funny
kind
how?
Of, how is that funny?
Like, you have a bunch of heads, like, on your shoulder, and you're
right.
Kind of walking down the street, and you're talking to people, and it's like a marionette. You kind of refer to them and stuff.
All right, here is Jeff wants to talk to you. Jeff, you're on Ron and Fez. Say hi to Bill, the intern.
Hello, Bill.
Hey, Jeff.
I knew this girl, and she used to take Adderall or Ritalin when we were going to have sex, and she had these crazy orgasms. Screaming, yelling, multiple orgasms, wondering if you've ever come across that, given it to your girlfriends or anything.
Bill?
No, I don't come across that with girls with Adderall. I've never really...
You don't have sex with girls?
Well, I don't want to shit where I eat.
Oh.
As it's, I think it said. Like, I don't... like the girl.
On a girl?
Well, the girls that...
That's why you don't shit on her pussy. Good thinking, Bill.
But I mean, like, you don't want to ruin a business partner...
Mm-hmm.
By...
Now, what girls are you talking about?
Specific people that...
On the O&A show?
No, people from
Pete?
School. Nah.
He thinks some of the interns are girls.
Oh.
So you don't think that you should be with girls at school?
No, I'm saying that I don't think that girls on Adderall that I would... Or girls that I might be...
Shitting on them.
Lending Adderall shouldn't... I don't really know whether or not... They would have a better orgasm because
you're spinning
Adderall.
Out of control.
So in this metaphor, the Adderall is shit,
or the girl
who's shit.
Well, girls are shit, so therefore, I think it all kind of.
What about Jodie Foster? I know you want to impress her. How would you impress Jodie?
Shooting.
No, no, don't say it because that's a wrong answer.
Oh, my bad.
That's a wrong answer. Nothing violent.
You would send her your script and try to get her to star in it.
I'll tell you, he'd be better off. I mean, if he did that, they'd pick him up in a heartbeat.
She would be in doing it.
You know what? I read his comedy and didn't sleep for 3 nights.
What comedy?
3 nights. Your funny movie script.
I'd hate to see you write a slasher film.
I think if people could get past the opening scene,
yeah,
then they would get the movie.
Without puking.
The opening scene's a little aggressive because we wanted to set the tone.
It did set the tone. It really did. That's why I couldn't sleep like I was on Adderall for 3 nights. Here's Brian. Brian, you're on Ren and Fez.
I'm fairly certain that Adderall is in the class of drugs that we call an antipsychotic, like Risperdal, which is typically prescribed for schizophrenics.
Any of the all seem like they're antipsychotic.
I'm pretty sure. Well,
what kind of shape were you in? Why did they decide to put you on this drug, Bill?
I was getting in a lot of trouble at school, and in an attempt to have any high school career at the school I was going, we kind of plea bargained that I would see a psychiatrist.
Mm-hmm. What were you doing that was so bad?
Last 2 years of high school, I got really, all my friends got kicked out. I was, like, the only kid there that I was new. I didn't really have friends there, and I was
Were they imaginary friends? Like, in Beautiful Mind?
Or two heads sitting on your shoulders?
Just two people I know. And,
You know not to juggle heads, right?
Nah.
Because that's wrong. That's what we've learned.
It's a bad thing.
Right. It's a bad thing.
Whew. But, just got in trouble, and we went, and then my mom, the doctor's like, here, try Adderall. I'm like, I'm not taking any drugs you prescribe me. And my mom basically bribed me to take it.
Even though she was dating other people?
Yeah.
While your dad was dying?
Yeah, and cheating on him and going out at night.
Was she?
I don't know. I'm going to leave it at that.
All right, let's play word association game. Whore.
Mom.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's what I was worried about. I'm not even going to do the rest of the test. Let me try it again. Whore.
Mom. Mm.
Actually getting a quicker reaction.
Mm. Yeah. Faster. All right, we're going to take a break, and we're going to be right back. Trying to be an amateur psychologist here. You got something for us, Earl?
Yeah, this is courtesy of Blowhard.
What is it?
It's we always play like weird outtakes of celebrities going crazy. And
yeah, who's this one?
This is Mr. Howell, Jim Backus.
All right, good. We're right back, Ren and Fez.
This is Jim Backus for Levy's Lazy Boy Shop. For years, you've identified me with... I can't believe... Number one, I ordinarily do not read this kind of shit. However, that's no excuse for being a total fuck-up and a screaming incompetent. Turn it on. Slate. I'm going to sell this piece of shit if it's the last thing I do.
We're on a Fez show. We got Bill the intern hanging out with him a little bit, finding out what drugs he's on. With all the younger guys, Fez, you got to figure out what drugs they're on.
Yeah, and it seems like just about everybody on something.
Right. Everybody called Tom Cruise this lunatic by acting like the shrinks are handing out too many drugs. Here you see this guy, Bill, who's a healthy young man, but has to take drugs to come in here and do his internship.
And how long you been on drugs? Prescribed drugs?
Well, I wouldn't really consider them drugs as much as a just like a way of life, you know?
Yeah. I was on drugs as a way of life, too. People called me a drug addict. But that's a whole different thing.
But, I probably two years now.
Yeah.
That's how long you've been seeing the psychiatrist and stuff?
Yeah, same prescription, basically. And just on and off. I used to, but up until the internship, I really only been taking it once or twice a week. Mm-hmm. Now it's like... not much, but I take it probably 4 days a week, 5 days
about
a week.
About 4 or 5 days a week.
Yeah.
And on the weekend you crash?
I definitely don't take any on the weekend.
Sleep all weekend?
I try not to, but sometimes I fall asleep. Like on a Friday, it'll be a Sunday when I wake up.
I understand. Do you ever hear voices?
No.
Next time when you get yourself in one of these drug-induced stupors, I just want you to remember, without Harry, the rest of your life would go well. And people would like you.
Yeah, I definitely feel he's holding me back.
If Harry's gone, you win. If Harry's gone, you win. If Harry's gone, you win. If Harry's gone, you win.
He's like some type of filter.
If Harry's gone, I win.
Kill Harry. Kill Harry.
Kill Harry.
Harry. Harry's the devil. Harry's the devil. Kill Harry. No. Kill Harry. Stab him. Stab him. You'll feel good. Kill Harry. Whatever. Take another pill. Pills are good. Pills are good. Take another pill.
Well, I always got some backup.
Yeah. You don't like women? You don't date them?
No, I do.
But the main problem is those...
I hate that mentality.
That Long Island mentality.
Like that whole shallow, Italian princess thing.
Boy, and with Italians.
I don't know. I'm half Italian, so...
Yeah, so... And so is Mom?
Mom's 100% Italian.
Mm-hmm. So you hate Italian women.
So
like
you...
Good Mom.
You don't want a gal like Gerald Dad married.
No, that's definitely something.
Not the way he ended up like a magnolia with Bill hanging over him crying. It's not going to stop till you wise up. Hey, Keith. Keith, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, what's going on, man?
Yeah.
I take Adderall. I've taken Ritalin, but they got some new stuff out. It's called Silert. They basically take Ritalin. And it's the purest form of whatever the active ingredient in Ritalin is.
Yeah.
They bring it down to Silert, and they you take 5 or 10 milligrams of that, and that's like taking quadruple the dose of Ritalin.
Yeah.
But I've been on that stuff for about 4 or 5 years. It really helps you, function. If I don't take it, I can't get my stuff done.
You can't get high. Right. I understand. I was the same way with crank. But now, Fezzy, it's like if the doctor just said, you know what, you're lazy. Here, let me roll up this dollar. I want you to snort this rail. That's where we are with the shrinks now. And everybody acted like Tom Cruise was some kind of moron because he said, no, I'm worried about the psychiatrist.
Now, doesn't it give you, like, the shakes or anything? I mean, isn't that...
Look at this kid. He's pale. He doesn't eat. He's pulling out his fingers. He's fucking wired.
I wouldn't be able to have the feeling of my heart beating out of my chest.
Yeah, sometimes you try to sleep, and it's just like, dun-dun-dun, and you're like, oh, man.
Why don't you beat Fez's heart out of his chest for him? 866-RON-0-FEZ, 866-RON-0-FEZ. Hey, Joe. Joe, you're on the Ron and Fez show. How you doing, buddy?
Hello.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Joe.
Hey, my kids take Ritalin, and, they were taking Ritalin, and they said they didn't go to school without it. We switched to the Adderall, and they don't need it. One of them takes it, and if he didn't take it, he couldn't notice. But the younger one, if he don't take it, it's like, winding up a yo-yo and just letting it go. He's just all over. So I don't know. I think it has neat basis.
Unless he takes the drugs, does he act childish?
Well, no, he gets real moody with it, but if he doesn't take it, he's just like, he had a pound of sugar and he just ate it all at once. He just goes nuts, and you can really tell.
Have you ever worked on the diet with him? Do you ever?
Well, me and his mother are divorced, and I get him every weekend, but he eats a normal diet in my house. I don't know what he gets at his mother's house.
You know what I recommend, Joe? Just give him the pill. Seriously, just give him the pill. Here's son. Hey, son, just rest.
Crush it up into his juice.
Yeah, crush it up into his juice.
Oh, no, they take it willingly. It's not that they don't
who wouldn't?
Take it.
I've always taken it willingly, too.
So yeah. They say if I don't give it to him on the weekends, that his level will drop and he's bad in school. I notice, he has bad reports on Monday and Tuesday when I don't give it to him, so I've pretty much been ordered to give it to him when I have it on the weekends.
Hey, it's better to get the good report card no matter how cranked up you got to get him. I'm agreeing 100%.
All I'm hearing is good things about Adderall. So.
Sure. It's great, isn't it?
Yeah.
A lot of work getting done, apparently.
Mike, you're on Ron and Fez.
What's up?
Yeah.
Bill definitely has mother issues.
No. Really? You think so?
crazy mother Italian issues.
Sir, do you have a license?
Here's the thing. Bill, your mother had you, but you never had her.
Yes.
You needed her, but she didn't need you.
Yes.
John Lennon put it best for you, right? In the song Mother.
Yeah. Yeah.
Would you ever want to talk to her on the air one day? Work some of this stuff out?
Sure, but it might turn into a me just... Because any situation where I'll get annoyed by her, I'll just chew her out.
Does she know you feel this way?
Does
she know that
she
you
does.
Think that she's a hooah?
I don't think she thinks I think that, but she definitely knows I have problems with her and the way she works.
So yeah. you get in screaming matches with your mother?
Nah, it's usually me screaming, or I don't scream.
It's just one-sided.
I'm like, I just say such nasty, hateful things that just shuts her up.
Sometimes I think you're alone in that motel, and you just say that it's your mom up there that you're talking to. At the Hotel Bates. The Motel Bates.
Well,
you can end up in her clothes, Bill.
Like he hasn't.
See, I stay away from mom and brother. I don't really have anything to do with them.
You see the one that mom likes better?
For the purposes of this, I'll say yes.
You think so? You think anything's happening between those two? And your fantasies, at least.
No.
What's the worst thing you've screamed at your mother when you were letting her have it? The worst thing you've called her to...
I don't know what the... Well, I find saying things about people's appearance, or a women's appearance, is the most hurtful things you could say to them.
Nice.
Like, you're fat or you're ugly, that's worse than saying the C word, because that's stuff that
right.
they can't really fix.
So is she fat and ugly?
No, but
I... And beautiful.
No, but...
Arousing?
No, but... I definitely have said a lot of mean things about her, to her and about her. And
what's the worst?
I don't know. I've blamed her for dad dying a few times.
Yeah, you killed my dad?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's something.
And because what does she care? It was her husband.
She got all the insurance money. She doesn't care.
Right.
Sure.
Now we have a house in Florida.
So
with the insurance money?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What part of Florida?
Naples.
Nice area. I wouldn't mind banging your mom one weekend and just having a getaway, doing a little golf and thug style. Here's Jason. You're on with Bill, the intern.
How you doing, guys?
Yeah.
I just want to know, whatever happened, you have all these issues and stuff, just taking a good hit of LSD, good old LSD, you know, you have a good trip for a weekend down the desert and you're cured.
You know, it is kind of true. Have you tripped?
Honestly, no. I don't know where to... Every time I've...
Yeah, you don't get it from a doctor. You got to go out on the streets. That's where the difference in generations. You sit around by yourself taking these pills, and me and my friends would do acid and smoke hash together and listen to music and meet chicks and have fun.
Honestly, hallucinogenics are really the only thing haven't done.
Well, I don't think you should. I'm not sure if you've got the psyche for it, my friend. I see you running down the street naked with a knife, screaming, I'm taking back the planet. And I don't want to be, you know, I don't want you caught up that way. But it did seem like, even though we did drugs illegally, we were having fun with it, where this generation's just fucking wired all the time on it.
Yeah.
And they're by themselves.
It's not recreational.
Here's, John. John, you're on Run a Fez.
Hey, I just want to know what Bill thinks about idiots like Tom Cruise, who says that these drugs are not only no good for them, but are probably hurting people like him.
I think that probably 90% of the people on stuff like Adderall shouldn't have it.
Right.
But there are people who do need specific things. And
are you one of them? You can't work without it, can you?
I think I could. I know I could, because I've done it before, but it's not like...
Well, you got to go weeks at a time.
We mean weeks at a time on it,
to
or
see whether it works. Oh. I mean, anybody can do one day anything.
I've been weeks over the summer not taking it, but I don't know about a total work situation like this where
what
I'm waking up
do?
At 4:20.
You just wouldn't have the energy.
I think it would be more, I would be doing everything everyone asked me, but I think little things would be messing it up. Like, I wouldn't be doing things right, or the phone screening things would just be a little worse.
Right.
So do you feel like you're addicted to it? If you think you could live off of it?
Psychologically, he's already addicted. I don't know whether he is physically, but when you feel like you have to have it to work.
Physically, I don't think I am, because, and I always talk to my doctor about this, but he doesn't care. He's just getting his, kickback from the drug rep, so.
Yeah, the drug rep's nothing worse. Andrew, you're on Run a Fez.
What's going on, boys?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was wondering if you could get Harry some Adderall, maybe, so he could step it up.
Absolutely not a bad idea.
Watch it out.
Harry, come slouching in here, you slack-jawed son of a bitch. You got nothing that this kid Bill has because you refuse to go the whole distance. You refuse to take the drugs.
I feel like that would only hurt me. I can't.
How do you know?
I don't want
to
find out.
If we send you to the shrink, would you be willing to take the drugs?
No, I don't like
it. It's that self-defeating attitude that's
good.
Good,
thank you, Bill.
What do you know? You're high on Adderall.
So what? He's getting his work done.
I'm going 100 miles an hour.
What we care about, he's on top of his game.
One day he's going to be in here with a six-shooter, though. Like, there's a balance above.
I'm willing to take that, and with a six-shooter, where is he going? The Old West? Where is he going to get this six-shooter?
I meant to say revolver, and I couldn't think of it quick enough.
You said six-shooter. Like suddenly Jesse James still rides the planet.
Well, I'll tell you what, if that happens, I'm closing the saloon.
Good one, Fez. Way to bring back slappy pants. Bill. Bill, hey. You're on Fez.
How are you?
Hey, buddy.
Is it not me, or is the entire country just completely over-medicated?
Well, I know this. There is a huge generation of kids, college-age, school-age kids, high school and college, that every one of them will come in here and tell you what meds they're on.
Yeah, it's definitely a increase in the past 3 years on kids taking medication.
Legally. I mean, we always used to take medication, but again, we did it for fun.
Yeah.
Are you warned not to drink with your medicine that you take, Bill?
No, not really. I mean, actually, kids take it to drink so you could drink longer and be more awake, you know, and it works.
Here's Keith, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, guys, what's going on?
Yeah.
Question. Bill.
Yo.
Listen, my question is this. Have you been diagnosed with ODD as well?
Oh, he's ODD, all right. I'll fucking swear to that. He's odd.
Well, yeah, true.
Yeah.
Oh, but the problem is, like, if you look at the efficacy of the substances that are used in this, mostly like Adderall XL, any of those types of narcotic, you're looking at an efficacy rate of the fact that with ODD and ADHD in adults and adolescents, when they mostly mature, you see that these effects have a diminishing factor of times two. So, I mean, I don't know what you guys are thinking about with that, but either way.
What?
Now you sound like a psychiatrist.
Just give him the pills and let him lay down. Hey, Tim. Tim, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Tim, go ahead.
I think Bill's got some serious respect issues with his mom. Somebody just needs to beat the snot out of him and teach him a little bit of respect for yelling at his mom and stuff. That's not right.
I don't yell at my mom. I tell her the truth about things because she refused to accept things.
And who the hell are you to judge your mother? She probably did the best that she possibly could with what she had to work with. And then she gets some kid like you that thinks...
Oh, yeah, she did the best she could, walking, never being home all the time, and I had to be, drove home by other people and then sit home until 10 p.m. when she comes home every night. Makes sense.
So you were hurting from a little age, huh?
Yes.
You were little Bill.
Yes.
Miss Mommy.
Yeah. Well, I don't know about that, but...
What's wrong?
No, it's just more like... Actually...
Yeah, but when you think of that little kid now... You wish that he had somebody with him, right?
Well, it's not that I have a problem with my mom. It's just over the whole dad thing. Because the truth is...
Yeah, but let's talk about you. You're a little kid.
Yeah.
And you're by yourself. And how did you feel?
Alone.
You were alone. And how's that feel?
Bad.
Right.
But then you get used to it.
With Adderall?
No, I don't... More just...
So you were used to, what age were you, all by yourself, sitting alone?
Six.
Yeah. Till 10 o'clock at night.
Well, I mean, parents would be home. This really didn't end up happening until late high school when this all started going, when I started driving. Because it was actually more my dad that wasn't around. Like, he was there, but he was a workaholic, so he was always doing stuff around the house. Like, I'd never been to a fast food place with my dad or anything like that. He was always home, and I always talked to him, but it wasn't that father-son relationship. And we had a lot of stuff we hadn't worked out.
What about this? Would you be willing to accept this for free? And Fez and I will pay to sterilize you. So this ends now with this generation.
I'll pay for an ad.
I want you to think about yourself when you were young, right? Okay. You're six and you're sitting there listening to this song on the radio. And just tell your mom and dad what you really need from them now. What would you need, six-year-old Bill?
Friends.
Why? You're ugly and stupid. Why do you need friends? No one loves you. Your mom doesn't love you and your dad doesn't love you.
That's true.
They'd be there.
My life is like the comic book Calvin and Hobbes.
Mm-hmm.
Just like wander around the woods.
True, if Calvin was whacked out on drugs, shitting himself, and thinking about killing his mom. Here, this will help you. Alright. Danny just brought this in. You, this is something. Was this written by you, Bill? The official Opie and Anthony movie.
I knew you were saving that for one time, but yeah, a friend and I. Well, my friend and I write scripts for a living.
For a living, you get paid?
Really?
No, we don't get paid.
Oh, okay. So that's
we
not
do,
for
while you're living. You write scripts while you're living.
But the movie, we wrote that as a joke.
Uh-huh.
And we only we never even completed it, but it's like absolutely insane.
And it's like have ONA seen this?
I don't know. Have they?
Let's see. It opens with Greg, a pasty, skinny little Irish boy.
Well, my friend and I both co-wrote this when we were fans, just sitting around.
What?
Because we weren't able to. The main script we wrote, we were having trouble. We were at a time when we couldn't be filming because our actors quit. So we were just writing different things. We wrote about 50 short things.
This is stalkerish and scary, man.
No, it's just stupid, and it has so many inside jokes in it. That's what makes it funny.
So this starts out with ONA as kids?
Yeah, it's actually a fake...
Yeah, I like this part when Opie yells, "I hate my fucking name."
Well, that's how we got the name. We just made like a continuous storyline to how they met, and it's stupid. The only reason we made it was so that it would be
this friend of yours.
It was never meant to be read.
Is it really you?
Nah, it's this big guy.
Mm-hmm. Big guy that only you can see.
Hobbs.
But,
is that why you're Calvin and Hobbes?
I don't
you
know.
You had imaginary friends?
I just said something.
I know, but now...
It's all
you know,
a bit.
Oh, is it? None of this is really happening, is it? You're back in your room, high on your drugs. None of this is happening. It's all just a bit, he yells.
No, it's
wow.
Just what it is.
The so that's official Opie and Anthony movie...
It's a prequel.
I brought that in as an example of how I and my friend write, so people, because I didn't want to show anyone our actual script before someone read that, because that will give you more an idea how the ridiculous standpoint we come from.
I like this. Anthony, this is the way the film ends. Anthony drops his tool belt, and they embrace, and Opie, and they're both crying, Opie yelling, "Never leave me again, never." Anthony says, "I won't. We'll be together forever."
That's not it. We just stopped making.
Why was this creepy weird?
We just stopped making the script. It comes from a very It comes from a To Kill a Mockingbird, like 1950s, like really lame standpoint.
Why is there jizz stains all over this?
I don't know. It's been Danny's possession for 3 months.
Are you saying you didn't fuck the script?
No.
Did you find the part where Anthony kills his wife?
No.
I think that's mid-script somewhere.
No, he doesn't. No. This got to be... It's out of context, this is going to make me seem... It makes it sound really bad.
I can't imagine it in context.
So you're fantasizing stupid about those two crying and hugging.
No,
have
it was a throwaway script.
Have they seen it, Dan?
I remember showing it to them. I don't know if anybody actually read it word for word. It might have just been something that they had looked at.
I think it
should be handed over to Master Paul.
You're probably right.
Nothing else will fit in the Bill file.
You get this back if none of us get killed, Bill. That's the only way you get this back.
Oh, what's the matter now? They're going to definitely want to read it now.
And you said it's inspired from To Kill a Mockingbird?
No, it's like that
1950s... Which one is Boo Radley?
It's just meant to be... Well, man, I look so bad now.
No.
I knew you were holding on to that.
Had you been asking for it back?
I brought it in so people could read it. I'm not hiding it from anyone. But it's got to be read in context because it's so stupid and ridiculous.
Yeah.
And it's like every inside joke from the Opie and Anthony show in a...
Nothing funny here. Just so you know.
Earl, can you turn down your microphone? My God. We heard the countdown blasting through the other headset.
I thought that was one of those things where only we could hear him, not everybody could.
It was, but he only did it in Danny's headphones.
Oh.
But I could hear it across the room coming out of Danny's headphones.
These cans are so loud it came back into the microphone.
I was trying to whisper it. I was like 10.
Oh, boy.
I don't fucking care. I'll post that script. It's not something I'm trying to hide. It's just...
Sure you don't care, man.
We wrote so many different things that involved different people. Like, we just wrote that as a throwaway. It's
stupid.
Has
your doctor seen it?
Nah, that gook. He doesn't read anything I do.
What?
He's a what?
Asian man.
Oh. I guess since you saw Apocalypse Now, that's how you refer to him. Ooh. Odd kid. Well, there it is. A lost generation, Fezzy. Lost on the drugs that we gave him.
That's what it leads to.
Please hand that over to the authorities after what other death takes place here.
After the DNA samples are taken from it.
And here's the interesting thing, Bill. You're still our number one intern. Even after we find out all these things, you're still way better than Bobby and Paulie.
Thank you. TiVo alerts tonight. Somebody's supposed to be getting killed on Lost and on Fox on Trading Spouses, The God Warrior, Part 2.
Oh, yeah. Did we ever hear from Al? We were supposed to go out with him for lunch.
He'll be here any minute.
He's coming here?
Yes.
Interesting. Tell him to bring his wallet.
Cover up the foosball table.
That's it for us. Take care, everybody.
The Ron and Fez Show. XM 202.